Hello everyone, this is Mundan Nagaman. In today's video, we are going to see how to read the image by using the OpenCV library. So we'll go to the first line. So first line, as usual, it is like importing statements for different libraries, which are like CV2, Matplotlib, and the NumPy. We are downloading or we are just importing all the modules. Then after directly, I'm going to read the image. So before starting the image reading, we will show what are the images we are going to use in this video. One is the modern art, this one, and another one is the puppy image. First, I'm going to read the natural, or let's say modern art image. So for that, just cv2.imageread, imread, then the path of the image. Then it will be loaded into the variable img. But here the point to be noted is, the image loading will be in the order of BGR, blue, green, and red. However, the image will be in the RGB layer, but when it's cv2 reads, it will be reading in the BGR format. So in order to execute with matplotlib, you need to again convert that into RGB. So next one, as we loaded the img, just we will see the type of this one. So type will be numpy nd array. For example, if I change anything, something different, let's say tt, okay, it's the wrong path. Just if I execute this one again, then if I execute the image type, it will be the none type. That means that it will not give any error if you mention something wrong path or the wrong image name. So again, we will execute. Again, we will execute. It will be the numpy nd array. And then after, we will execute the image shape. So image shape will be 352 and 234. This is the resolution or pixel size, length into breadth. But however, we have the third dimension, which are like RGB. So since it's a three color, so we will be having the three dimension. So then after PLT IM show, just I'm going to execute directly as it is. So you are seeing like this, right? But if you see the actual image, so it will be something like that. But you are seeing like a blue color with maximum, right? The reason behind this one is, as we see, CV2 reading the image in the BGR format. So it is reading from the BGR, but actually PLT uses the RGB format. So that's the reason it's mismatching, and we are getting something different output rather than the actual output. So for that reason, again, we are going to convert that image source, because we read the image through the img, it is in the BGR, but we are showing that image by using the matplotlib. So both are having the different format. It is BGR, here it is RGB. In order to use inside the, let's say, matplotlib, we need to convert BGR into RGB. The same thing, we can convert cv2 dot convert color img, the source of that wherever we read. Then after cv2 dot color BGR. BGR is our format now because we read through the CV2. Then we are converting into RGB. Now we have converted and it will be saved into the image converted. Then after, now if we start to execute or if we start to show the image by using the matplotlib, because now the image converted, it's in the format of RGB, which matches with matplotlib. If you just execute, you will see the real image and you can compare with the actual one. Now we have completed this reading the image and we have converted that BGR into RGB. We are showing as it is. This is the first step. Next one, we are going to see the image as a grayscale image. In order to see the grayscale image, just you need to add one more parameter or one more argument, which is like CV2 IM read grayscale. In that case, it will be loading the image with grayscale. So that means that it will have only one dimension. Why? Because in color images, we need to have RGB layers, but in case of grayscale, we have only black and white. So for that, we don't need the three dimension. So that's the reason you can see here only the length and breadth of the image, and you will not see the third dimension, which is representing the RGB, right? So next one, we are going to see the image, but however, in matplotlib, it will be using its own color map. So color map, in the sense, if you are having only one dimension and if it will be in the single color, but the color will be differing based on the color map. So for that reason, we need to explicitly mention what is the color map we want to use in the image. Even though the image is loaded with image grayscale, but we need to mention color map as gray. So then only the color map will be looking like this. So just execute this one and see, you will be having the grayscale image. Just imagine you don't have that image, I mean, you don't have the color map, then execute, you will be seeing something different. So that's the reason we need to use. So for that reason, we are using always the color map. Even sometime you will have different color maps, for example, magma, and just execute, you will be having the different color scale or color map, sorry. So for that reason, we are just going to use gray. Now you can see the grayscale image. Now till now we have seen the first line, It is just like importing statements, and then we have seen the reading the image file JPEG format, and we have read and we have seen the type of the image, and we know that if you are just a different format, if it is a different format, you will be getting none type rather than the error. Then after you have seen the image shape, so it will be the three dimension because we have the RGB. Then in order to show inside the matplotlib, so we need to convert the BGR into RGB. That I have done, and we have seen the image as it is. Then we have seen how to load the grayscale image by using the another argument CV2 EMRead grayscale. Then after we have seen the shape of that, it is a grayscale, so it will have only two dimension, will not have the third dimension. Then after you have seen how to show the image by using the grayscale color map. Now we are going to see another level. In RGB color model, we have seen every image will have three layers of image, right? So RGB. So we are going to see how to segregate these three layers. The first line, as usual, CV2, IMRead, ImageRead, the puppy image, and you can see the puppy image variable. Now I am going to convert this because you know that CV2 reads in the BGR, but in order to use inside the matplotlib, you need to convert into RGB. So for that reason, as usual, the same line, I am converting into the RGB format. Then PLT IMShow, it is converted. Now I am displaying this image. Now it is coming as it is. If you compare with the actual image, you can see the same image here. But here you can see the length and breadth because you have seen the shape, right? Shape is 352 and 234. So here it is. 234 and 352. So it is 352, it is 234, I think. Yes, exactly. And as we discussed, the image writing will be starting from your left side to right side, from top to bottom. The same way it is going and it is working. Now, we need to have the image copy because we are going to create three different images which are like only two dimension, which does not have the RGB all. It will be having any one of that. So in order to do that, I'm just copying the puppy image.copy. See here, I am not loading that image. That's the reason you will be having the same RGB format. It will not have the, let's say GPR. So sorry, BGR. It will not have the BGR because you are not reading the image by using the CV2. Just I am copying the image. Then you consider this image will have now three dimension because the image itself will have three dimension RGB by default. Now in order to get the blue image RGB, so I need to just make the first two dimension as zero, all the values, because here you can use the rows and columns. As we know that this is a NumPy array. So all the rows, all the columns of the first dimension, which are R, will be set to zero. That means that all will be nullified. The same way for all the rows, all the columns for the second dimension, which is for green, that will be make it as zero. So that you are nullifying R and G totally by using the value zero. Then you will have only the B, that is blue image. Now you can just display the blue image because here we don't have any problem because we don't have any three dimension. We have only one dimension, remaining all are zeros. If you execute this one, you will be getting the blue image. The same way for red image or green image. You can consider next one is green image. So RGB. So that means that first one and the last one should be nullified with zero. So the third dimension and the first dimension, so it will be equal to zero. So that's what we are doing here in these two lines with all the rows and columns of that image. That means that all the pixels. So it will be make it a zero. Then you will have only the green image. So next one, the same way for the red image. So RGB. So the first one should be there and remaining two should be just make it as a null or zeros. So for that, we are just using these two lines and we are making that 0, 0 for all the other colors like G and B. Then we will be having only the red image. If you execute this one, you can see only the red image. So this is all about this video. So in this video, we have seen how to read the image by using the IMRead. By default, it will be reading through the BGR format, and we know how to convert this BGR into RGB by using the CV2.CV convert color. Then we have seen how to make the image grayscale image by using another argument. And we have seen in order to display inside the matplotlib, we need to definitely mention the color map as a gray to see the grayscale image. Then after we have seen how to see the different color images, for example, R separately, G separately, B separately, red image, blue image, and green images. So in order to do that, we have set up other two dimension as a zero, then we have seen the remaining scale. So thanks all, thanks for watching and have a great day.